einmal der Titelverteidiger. Wir begrüßen Malin.
Welcome everyone to the AWD Dome Bremen in Germany for the first men's semi-final of the World Team Table Tennis Championships. And I tell you, there is a fantastic atmosphere here in the AWD Dome this afternoon. The spectators are hoping for some kind of miracle as home favourites Germany take on the mighty and seemingly invincible Chinese. That team is just being introduced to the crowd as I speak, with Ma Lin, Wang Lijin and Wang Hao being introduced, and there the Chinese flag. Great support here, of course, for the favourites in the World Championships, and of course, long-time favourites, but now, there he is, Thibaut Boll, the home crowd favourite, number two in the world, and the German team pulled off a great surprise in Qatar a couple of years ago, rocked the table tennis world by taking silver against the odds. And that team comes back to try to go one better this time round. It's going to be a real tall order because the Chinese are superior in all ways of the game, in the physical and the mental strength. But I tell you what, this home crowd support is huge. Nearly 10,000 people here in the AWD Dome. And the German coach and his team, I tell you now, will be very, very up for this one. Dirk Schimmelpfennig. Week here in Bremen, over 800 competitors from something like 146 nations have taken part in this competition, and I can tell you it's been brilliant, not just on the court within the playing area, but all the way around. We've had a great exhibition, we've had a museum here for people to see, we've had competitions throughout the week. And the atmosphere is building now as pressure comes on the German boys. But let me tell you, the Chinese have not taken it easy, that's for sure. There's Thibaut Boll. He'll be looking for something from really special from him. And 26-year-old Ma Lin there just in shot. He's had a word with his coach Liu Guoliang. And they'll be underway in just a couple of moments. Lona Vitved of Denmark is the umpire, assisted by Bill Walk of the USA. And that is a wonderful sight. And let me tell you, every single one of those 10,000 are on the edges of their seats before it even starts. So, down to business then. The World Team Table Tennis Championships, semi-final stage, AWD Dome Bremen. And it's the opening match, Thibaut Boll of Germany against Ma Lin of China. It's going to be Ma Lin to serve. Well, we can hear what the crowd think of it. They may well yet have a big influence. Marlin in service. And already a super drive there on the forehand side, heavy topspin. First point, first blood, China. Oh, beautiful disguise. Whoa. Timo comes in with a fabulous disguise. He looked as if he was going to drag it cross table, pushed it down the line for a beautiful first point, one all. Now picks up the service. And another super shot. May have just touched the top of the net, but that's a good drive. Watch this one, coming up now. Ooh, it did, it just touched the top of the net. Onto the edge and into the stomach, 2-1. Wow, it's so fast, it's so intense out there, right from the word go. Marlin looks composed, but I tell you what, his stomach will be churning at the moment, trying to get in the ascendancy in this opening game. 2-2. Some super shots to start. And that very important service from Marlin had a little bit too much spin for Timo. And 4-2 now, as Timo becomes a little bit anxious to put that heavy topspin away. Doesn't find the table, 4-2. In fact, it's 2-4 with Timo himself. The German crowd really trying to lift their number one player. And another error forced from Marlin. That backhand doesn't find the edge. Watch this, heavy topspin backhand. Overcooked, off the table. 5-2, 2-5. And again, he had the chance. A little tension in Timo Boll's play. Started out well to get the second point, but has now dropped back. 4 points adrift. A little anxious. Maybe the crowd are pumping him up too much. Marlin holding a good shape at the moment. Just defending well, not attacking, 6-2. And again, it's the attacking shot that's causing the problem from Timo Boll. 7-2. And if you can hear Chayo, Chayo being shouted, that's the Chinese support. I've got it on good authority, it means more oil, more fire. And that's the first time that Marlin has made a mistake since the second point. 3-7. It's a very, very tense atmosphere here. Opening exchanges. Very tight. Big point. Big point. And the fight back continues. 4-7. That was good stuff from Timo. He varied it, kept the pressure on, didn't allow Marlin his usual defensive position. He had to semi-attack as well. Forced the error. 4-7. And again, that's a big point from Marlin. What a big shout. 8-4. And that meant a lot to him. At this stage, that's a big point. If that fight back had continued... Ooh, Timo. Again, it's Marlin without a great deal of pressure there, forces that error. Huge, huge back take and sweep of that topspin, fails to make contact. And this time it's Marlin who makes the error. it's nail-biting stuff, there's no doubt about that. But Marlin holding a good position at the moment. This is a great point. Super point for Marlin. He had some excellent resilience. Look at the speed across the table there. Absolutely, look at the height on that heavy, heavy topspin forehand. What a beautiful shot. And that brings him now to game point at 5-10. Timo Boll up against it. That's a let. Ain't quite over yet. Ten-six. Too good. So the first game then to Valin of China. Timo Boll has got a big uphill battle here. Have a look at a review of a couple of these shots, but I tell you, it was the consistency of Marlin that won that particular game. The pen grip there, and it's too high, much too high set up there for Marlin. He'll eat those for breakfast. Timo Boll is finding the pressure a little bit much at the minute. Strictly speaking, on ranking order, he should be competing with Marlin. In fact, the crowd are hoping that he will do a little bit better in the subsequent games. But I can tell you now, Liu Guoliang, the Chinese coach, will be very, very happy. Trying to get his player up a little bit. Timo Boll, the crowd wants something special this game. Not too many chances to get into this. He's not got to be too aggressive. He's just got to contain and make the bad shots that Marlin plays suffer. But there you see, it's a big mix of spins. Well away from the body, Marlin, but he's still managed to get a lot of top on it. And another one. He's so, so fast. That is the shot, not only the shot on the table, but the shot of the camera of a very confident young man. 26-year-old Marlin in the lead, 2-love. And it's an easy, easy third point. Big disappointment. Oh, that undercut shot by Boll just wasn't going anywhere. Suffering some confidence moments at the moment. And another one. Boll is in trouble. He's just not finding the center of the bat. Crowd trying to lift him, but he's in trouble at love four. And at love five. And I tell you what, Marlin has not put a foot wrong this match so far. He has been absolutely superb. The Chinese are so, so keen to dominate forever. And why not? Look at that. Love six. And already the atmosphere in this AWD dome in Bremen is more subdued. The crowd trying to lift their hero, but it ain't happening. Marlin in control at 6-love. A better shot there, right into the body there from Timo Boll. He needs a few more of those off. It's got to put Marlin off his stride. He
He's reading everything at the moment, as Marlin. And again, oh, lovely response. Two in a row for Timo Boll. That was quick. Wonderful reflexes here. Reaching, keeping the top spin going. 2-6. Too good. Marlin continues to have the dominant perspective close to the net. He's prepared to really force it when he knows he's got that position at the net. Timo Boll down by 3-7 now. Oh, that was an amazing service. Incredible, right on the edge of the bat there. The pimples really doing their job. 7-3 to China, second game. Oh, great recovery. Oh, wow. That is the best rally of the match so far. Look at this from some amazing position. Below the height of the table, look at that. Absolutely superb backhand cross table. Wow, that is Timo Boll at his absolute best, and the crowd haven't stopped applauding. Wow, 7-4 to China, but Timo Boll fighting. Into the body there, that's too much from Marlin. Still keeps the ascendancy, but the crowd really fired up by that last rally. Just too difficult into the body. Timo in service at 4-8. And just caught the top of the net and out of table. Just off the top, yeah. And it was a brave effort, but it's now big, big problems for Timo Boll. Again, Marlin lifts his arm in triumph, forcing the error. Still 4 points adrift, Timo at 5-9. Well, they're not settling for short rallies, that's for sure. Marlin, 2 points away from taking the second game. Well, it's not done yet. There's a more positive body feeling from Timo Boll. You can tell he's up for it now. His body language is definitely a bit more positive. Having dropped back by 5-love, he's now within 3 at 6-9. Oh, that's good stuff. That is an excellent piece of play by Marlin. He's so fast. Look at the speed of this. Putting Boll on the back foot, literally. Forcing the error. Set ball is called at 10-6, 6-10. Boll in service. Ooh, 7-10. Again, the crowd right into this one. 7-10. And that's it, that is the second game, second set. And that is a brave fight back, but it ain't good enough as Marlin of China in this semi-final of the men's team event here in Bremen, in Germany, takes the second game, second set by 11 points to 7 and continues on with a very, very confident display. Timo Boll really playing catch up the whole time. Never ever able to dominate any of the exchanges. Played one brilliant rally to come back to 5 points. But thereafter, it was this man, Marlin, and his coach, Liu Guoliang, who will have all the smiles at the minute. Use your head, says Gualian. I'm absolutely certain he's already been doing that. 11-6, 11-7, Timo Boll, and the whole of Germany's expectations rest on this next game. If he can crawl back into this match, then we might have a semi-final to savour. Otherwise, it's going to be a procession for China, I'm afraid. Marlin is absolutely in charge. One love. And again, the crowd trying to lift it, hoping for something really special here. That's one all. Very ambitious shot attempted by Marlin, an inside-out forehand topspin. Lifted that elbow, pushed it too far. Oh, and again, aggression. Timo Boll tensed up there. Look at him, look at his body shape. So, so heavy on that one. Oh, disappointment for the world number two. Knows that he's got a real uphill task right here. Two all. Well, that was a really ambitious all-or-nothing shot from Timo. He was way outside on the backhand court, tried a forehand, didn't have enough height. Look at the space that Marlin had to work in, even if the ball had come back. Oh, that's better. That is so, so much better. This is what the German crowd have been used to seeing. That inside-out again, forehand, topspin. Look at it. Revved it right up, got down low, absolutely everything into that. We haven't seen that one come off. He's made too many errors attempting that shot during this match so far. And he picks up another point there. Hope springs eternal for the Germans at 4-3. That net just over 15 centimeters high, 15.25 centimeters. It looks nothing from here, but it's a big, big barrier when you're down in the cauldron of competition at this highest level of team sport. It's a great game. There's a whole bunch of pressure here, and Timo has just edged into a 5-3 lead. And another one at 6-3. And the crowd, can you believe it? They're actually standing to applaud, some of them. Such is the fanaticism of these supporters. It's a magnificent sport played in a great, great atmosphere here. 6-3. Timo Boll, can he do the impossible now? Come back from two love down. Pressure, it's all about pressure and confidence. Wow. Oh yes, oh yes. Ha. Timo Boll. From couldn't find a shot to can't miss at the moment. Look at that, absolutely superb. That is skill at the highest level. Magnificent shot from Timo Boll. He's having a great game at 7-3. Can he continue this progress? And another one at 8-3. Wow. When all appeared to be lost, the character of the man is coming through. This 25-year-old is not a national hero for nothing. He's now thinking, fight, 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 dig deep. 8-3. Great defense and super attack. Wow. That is astonishing. Timo Boll at the top of his game in this third set. And that is at 9-3, the best we've seen of him probably this whole tournament. Ma Lin, from a position of total dominance, is struggling to return the ball. Wow. 3-9. A magnificent game. Very, very high toss there from Ma Lin. And that's 10 now. 10-3, it's set point, game point. Timo asking for the serve again, this high, high toss. Umpire agrees, and that's it. It's given away by Ma Lin. Wow, that is something special at 11-3. Timo Boll suddenly comes alive. That really is brilliant pressure as Timo goes over the dirt. Schimmelpfennig. I tell you what, the hearts will be lifted. Well, I said the whole match would hinge on that game. What an inspired game by Timo Boll. Can he keep this going? The crowd hope he can. They're trying to get him up again to take this fourth game. He has to take this fourth one to force the rubber. He's in service, love all. That's a good start. Oh. He fell away after that shot, tripped up, but Ma Lin made the error. We haven't seen that too many times. Has the table literally turned? Ma Lin can see the funny side of it. Oh, but Timo Boll is not laughing. He's just absolutely flying at the minute. Look at this. Great shot. He took it so early, right at the top of that bounce. And Ma Lin is love two down. He's having to find some new shots. Oh, and that was just top of that 15-centimeter net. Look at the... it was a drive. There was no spin on it. It was going to be a straightforward drive into the body. Didn't happen. 1-2. This is a fantastic rally, and Ma Lin wins it. Beautiful defense initially by Timo Boll, but eventually it was too much for him to handle, 2-2. The Chinese flags are certainly in great prominence. But Timo still edges it. Again, an unforced error, really. Not a great deal on there for Ma Lin, but he tried to get a bit too aggressive. Off the table for 3-2. And another one for 4-2. Well, when the chips are down, they say the best come through. And Timo Boll is showing tremendous character. He was down and out, two sets to love down, and he's fighting for all he's worth. At 2-4, Ma Lin is in a battle. Let me tell you, it's quite cool inside this AWD dome. Ma Lin is sweating at the moment. 5-2. Look at that, absolutely superb. Well, everything was right there with that magnificent topspin forehand from Timo. And another one to make it 6. 4 points ahead. And what Ma Lin was attempting and working in the first two games is now not so easy for him. Timo Boll in the ascendancy, and the crowd absolutely lifting him higher still. Oh, yes. Marlin with a magnificent dummy there. Looked as if he was shaping cross and then opened up the face, lifted the, in fact, kept the elbow reasonably low and made it down the line. Ooh, and another fabulous shot from Marlin. He's certainly not going to sit back and watch. Too much for Timo to handle there. Just off the edge. 2 centimeters, that line at the side. That's what he was aiming for. Timo Boll of Germany, still 6-4 ahead.
Got it!
And now just 6-5. Realistically, the Germans have to win this opening match to stand any chance against the totally dominant Chinese force. And that is a very important point, because I think if he'd leveled up at that stage, having won 3 in a row, Marlin may well have gone on to win it. Not that he won't now, but this is giving Timo Boll a real opportunity, a 2-point gap at this stage, four to get. That's what it means to the German camp. Richard Prowls and Schimmelfennig really, really up for that one. Timo in service, 7-5. Oh yes, 7-6, 6. And again, it was so beautifully played by Marlin. He's so athletic, so fit, so agile. He had his opponent wondering what the heck was going to happen with that shot. It was beautifully played. Excellent shot. 1 point separates these two. The service is absolutely vital, and Timo played a ripper there. There is no lifting the ball from the palm of the hand with any spin, but everything comes on from the bat itself. Big point, big point, big point. Oh, yes. Again, leaving that table so well exposed. Timo Boll loves that forehand. Look at the way he's down for it. Over his head he played that, forcing the error, and look at the punches all the way around. Oh dear. Krauser and Schimmelfennig are playing every shot here. Yes! Oh wow, that is pressure. Timo Boll playing a fantastic match here on home soil. 10-6 he leads to level it and force the all-important rubber set. Well, he's got 4 chances to take this 4th set. It's so tense right here. It's in, that is the 4th set. Wow, just off the top of the net. A lucky break there for Timo Boll. But let me tell you, he did not need any more than a fantastic piece of table tennis play throughout that game, throughout that particular game. And 11-6, he has just lifted everyone in this crowd. 6-11, 7-11 down, and it all looked over. Then 11-3 in the third, now 11-6 in the fourth, and what's to say, who's to say, that he won't take the match as well. This is something special here at the World Team Table Tennis Championships in Bremen, and the Germans absolutely spellbound by this 25-year-old Boll, who is not only fighting for his life, he is showing some courage that we didn't think was possible. Look at this. What an atmosphere. 10,000 people lifting their arms and lifting their hero, Timo Boll, for one more set.
Und wir freuen uns auf den fünften Platz zwischen Marlene und Timo!
This is a very, very big game, a big set in these championships. Marlin, can he regain his dominance? Oh, I think that touched the edge. I've got a feeling that touched the edge of the table. It did. It picked up that 2 centimeter edge. Germany lead off the fifth set. One love. And again, a dominant forehand. Timo makes it 2. Well, you have to hand it to this young man. He is now in service at 2 love. And from a seemingly impossible position, he has come back to play some superb table tennis. Keeps the ball on the table, forces Marlin to miss it. 3 love. Look at the strength of his, of that powerful, powerful position with the feet. The legs are in great, great position to keep the power on. Very, very free movement of the arm. The non-striking arm is equally important to get that balance and power into a ball. And China, wow, who would have believed it? They've had to take a break. They've taken a timeout, and they're trying to get this one back on track. What a thrill for the crowd here in the AWD Dome in Bremen. The Chinese have been very vocal with their cha yo, cha yo. But I tell you, it's Timo, not cha yo, that's leading at the minute. The first time in the match, he's got a real good chance to make it 4. Look at that! What a brilliant shot! Wow! That is exciting play. Goodness me, look at this one. That forehand out of nowhere. Look at how far he's out and away. Marlin can't believe it. He can't believe how well Timo Boll got that one back from an impossible position across the table. 4 love. Oh, Timo, just one little error there. Marlin was always defending. And then just that little bit of extra gives away the point, but he still got the lead by 3. And another one from Marlin. Isn't it interesting how these things go in sequence? Marlin pounced on that one. Great speed across the table to get a very, very good shot down into the body of Timo Boll. And it's just 2 points the difference with Timo in serve at 4-2. At 4-3, so 3 in a row for Marlin. And the coaching staff for China, a little more relieved with that. What an exciting fifth and final set in this opening of the semi-final, the men's team event, China versus Germany. Oh, yes. 5-3. How did he get this one? It's just extraordinary the way he placed that one inside out. Kept his elbow down a little bit more. Spin. The ball kept moving out. And Marlin could pick it. So. 3-5. There's a lot of sweat there. And Timo Boll, win or lose this one, I tell you what, he has shown some fantastic fighting spirit. Marlin in service, 3-5. And again, forcing it. And that defensive ploy by Marlin doesn't come off. He misses the table, so Timo Boll makes it 3 points in the lead now. He loved this one. This was a very, very important point. It's such a tough game, this. Everything or nothing on one slight moment. That is another very important moment. Timo is up by 4 again, 7-3 he leads in this final set. And look at the team's anguish, and more anguish from Marlin as he lifts his eyes to the heavens for inspiration. He just can't quite get on terms here. Look at this, Germany with the serve, 7-3. Let me tell you, 4 more points, if they get those, they will be erupting here in this Bremen Dome. How do table tennis top players stay so much apparently in control when there's so much happening so fast? Oh, what a shot from Timo Boll. That was amazing. It was around the corner of the net. Look at that. Absolutely extraordinary. And he's now 3 points away from a sensational win. What a fabulous piece of play. Oof, Marlin can't believe it. Well, they said they feared him, and they had every reason to, the Chinese. This German golden boy is absolutely flying, but he isn't home yet at 4-8. He's got to get 3 more points, and he slipped a little bit there. It was good play by Marlin. Li Guoliang. The Chinese coach has said that Timo Boll is one of the finest players in the world. It's obviously his ranking says that. But in every respect, the Chinese coach, to give him that kind of respect, is fantastic. Well, 5-8. And Timo wants a timeout. He's got a lead of 3. He needs 3. Well, this is something special. We were hoping for a great matchup here. Germany certainly were going to be up against the wall. They'd lost 3-love in Doha a couple of years ago. And China was certainly looking for another clean sweep. They haven't lost any matches so far. And I can tell you, if the German can just hang in for get another 3 points, you won't be able to hear me over the din here in Bremen. Coming up to 45 minutes of the match gone. And that is a point for Timo Boll. And people will say, oh, well, that's a very famous German table tennis player.
Schuss.
And I can tell you, with two to go, the Germans are really up for this. And one go! 10-5, and the German number two in the world seeded, Timo Boll, has got match point. What a fight back, what an exciting game. Superb shot. This is match point. That is it! Wow, 11 points to 5 in the fifth. What a magnificent fight back. What a great start for Germany against the world champions, China. Well, this is a strategy that the coaching team from Germany have got absolutely right. Schimmelpfennig and Prowse have pitched their number one seed 11-6, 11-7 to Marlin. It was just so, so dominant. And then Timo Boll came through with a brilliant third game, faultless third game to 11-3. Held on to that position at 11-6 and then fought like he'd never fought before to make it 11-5 in the fifth. Schimmelpfennig, absolutely delighted. Two-fold singles world champion. This is now Christian Süss, 20 years old, a youngster, 56 in the world, a long way back. So he is the sacrificial lamb here, I think. Double Olympic winner, 2000. In the doubles of Olympic 2001, he was the two-fold team world champion in 2001-2004, singles world champion 2001-2005. He's a wonderful competitor, but a great character. Socially, a very, very well liked and loved, but Mr. Cool on the court. Look at that body, absolutely beautifully proportioned for this game. Tall, rangy, fast on his feet. He's got magnificent skills in every department. One of the fittest guys. One of the fittest sportsmen. And I tell you what, he is the clear favorite here. So, big chance here. Wang Lichin of China will open up. And his speed will have Christian Süss struggling. One love. Well, we went 55 minutes in the last match. This one could be over in 15 if it continues like this. It's love two. Christian Süss, love two down. Ah, picks up a good point there on the backhand. To remind you of a young Becker. Both right-handers, heavy topspin there from the center. Look at this, great leg position, good leg position, and a wonderful sweep. Süss can't get anywhere near. Puff out of the cheeks. He's frustrated that he can't get close. Oh, good shot there, though. That's two backhands that Süss has found the edge. Wow, Well, he might be world champion, Li Qin, but he still gets excited when he wins a point. 2-4, Suss will be serving. Now that was a great shot, and it all came from that wonderful serve of Christian Suss. It was much too strong. Very, very good spin on it. And that was forcing the error from Li Qin. So Suss again, just 1 point behind. Now he's leveled up at fours. Did I speak too soon? Well, quality will out, there's no doubt about that, but Suss putting up a good fight in these early exchanges. And again, Christian Suss matches shot for shot, pace for pace, backhand for backhand, and wins the point. 5-4, 4-5. Suss there did well to defend, but that ball coming so high meant that the heavy forehand top smash was just a matter of time for Li Qin. Levels at five. Wow. Well, that surprised him. Good, intelligent play by Christian Suss there. Fooled his opposite number from the service, 6-5. And another aggressive piece of play at the net. Suss is no mug, there's no doubt about that, but he's playing a very aggressive game, and it's a little bit unnerving for the world champion. 2 points adrift now at 5-7. And 5-8. And the crowd believe in miracles. A let there. This time, Li Qin comes through. Big, heavy topspin forehand. Onto the backhand side. Such quick reflexes required. 8-6, Germany still in the lead, opening game. This is brilliant, brilliant table tennis. It was a little bit of a quiet atmosphere during the rally, but I think people were spellbound by it. That final moment there, a little unfortunate for Christian Suss, but he played a brilliant part in that rally. And you can see what it means to Li Qin. 8-7. 8-8. German crowd trying to lift Christian Suss. And another great shot. He's two away from a surprise opening game win. There is no doubt this 10,000 home crowd is pretty intimidating. But so is Wang Li Qin when he gets going. 9-9. And that block from Suss wasn't enough. It was too high, giving Wang a real chance to force it. Oh dear, for Soos. He's played such a great part of this game. And it's now, it is set ball to Wang Lichin. Started out so confidently, fell back a little bit. Soos took over. The German crowd got lifted, but he's now facing. And that is set point gone. First set to China at 11-9. Christian Soos battled really well there. And it certainly gives the German crowd a little bit of hope. It's only one game. The final point. Soos really battled beautifully. The top of that 15.25 centimeter net, probably about 0.1 of a centimeter too high on that particular point. Well, it's certainly a question of celebration and dejection, isn't it? The Chinese support here and the Chinese bench taking this very, very seriously. They know that they've got a major, major battle here.
This is game number
Christian Soos is now starting the second game of this semi-final, the first semi-final of the men's team event here at the World Team Table Tennis Championships at the AWD Dome in Bremen. Soos really stands his ground, particularly on those backhands. The backhand into the body, he's very comfy with. Oh, yes. What a wonderful change. Look at that, the backhand. And watch the grip change in his hand, comes way over the top. That is super table tennis. What skills. Well, when you can do that against the world's number one and you happen to be ranked at 56, I guess you might feel pretty pleased.
1-2.
A wicked spin there, forcing the error. Germany still in the lead by one, by two now.
3-1.
Well, you can hear the score. And again, that net just pushing the ball wide. 3-2 Germany. And again, it was that backhand, look at it. The backhand into the stomach. But Christian Soos is so, so quick to cover up and to put back a very attacking shot. He holds a 2-point advantage against the world champion.
3-4.
Big point that for Lichin. So quick. And again, it was the change of spin. Always trying to keep his opponent guessing. Christian Soos plays a brilliant point there. It was a chop, underspin. Set up that error. 5-3. Lichin was called in two minds there. He got away with it. And of course, Soos just having to stretch a little bit too far, couldn't control. Still has a 5-4 lead. 6-4 now. Lichin. Just a little quizzical squeezing of the brows there. wondering why he made that basic error at 4-6. Oh, what a recovery. So dear. That was a magnificent piece of play by Suess. Look at that. And then he finds the net when he got aggressive. So far back from the table there. And it's leveled at 6-6 now. And again, just a bit too aggressive off the net, trying that heavy top down the line. But the crowd are still enthralled by this battle. The second match, Christian Suess is expected to lose, but he's giving Li Qin, the world champion, a tremendous workout. And there's another point at 7-6. Too fast. Li Qin, look at the speed that he leapt on that one. So aggressive, got right to the top of the bounce, made it dead. Now it's 7-7. Christian Suess, he knows that he's the underdog, but he's playing out of his skin at the minute, and don't they know it too? They'll be very proud of this battling performance by the German. 7-8. Nothing to lose, all to play for, and that's another point. And Christian Suess is a dangerous character because he knows he can just go for it. There's no pressure on him. It's all on the world champion. And the German crowd are really, really hoping for something spectacular. Yes, they got it there. Wow, that is just amazing. Suess has got all the shots and he's playing them with tremendous abandon. Wow. Li Qin has not been in this position for a while, under pressure from the crowd so much, and under pressure from a very, very talented young man. He's still got two set points, as Christian Suess, and he's got the advantage of a serve coming up. It's all happening here at the AWD Dome in Bremen, the first semi-final of the World Team Table Tennis Championships. Oh, and that was almost it. It was so close, forcing it, not trying to spin. Just have a look at this. Quickly onto the top. Nope, nothing there, because the net just took the ball away. 9-10. Oh, wow, what a defense by Wang. Christian Suess thought he had worked a miracle getting that ball back. Look at that. And then, inside out, Li Qin levels it at 10. Deuce ball. Wow. A puff of the cheek says it all there. Suess had an advantage of 3, and it's gone. And now it's lost to set ball now to Li Qin. You can't let this man get any space at all. That shows great character to come back 3 down. 3 set points gone, and now he's just taken it by 13. 13 points to 11 in the second. He leads by 2 love. Wow, that really was something special by Wang Li Qin of China. can tell it means a lot to him to come from that position back. He was 10-7 down, facing the service, and then put a sequence of 5 points together that tells the world he's still number one. Guo Liang on the right of screen there. Oh, yes. If you want to show any clip of this championship, just check that out for aggressive play. Christian Suss was stretching this way and that way. He was being pushed and harried and pulled around by Wang Lijin, who then finished it off with an absolute ripper. Germany serving at 1-2. At 2-2. That favorite little shot of Christian Suss from the stomach on the backhand just let him down a little bit there. He loves that. Just a bit too aggressive. 3-2 China with the serve. Three all. I must say, Christian Suss has played brilliantly well. He went to deuce in the second. He was at 9 in the first. And he's level at 3-3, so he's really giving the world champion a fantastic run out. Li Qian turns defense into aggression, but overcooks this one. Watch this heavy, heavy top way beyond the table. Wow, first major mistake from the serve. And that is a real, real poor, unforced error from Suss. Again, it's the backhand that causes the damage. Such pace, such speed from Li Qian. Got into good position early. A brave effort by Suss to get it back. And another good shot from Suss on the forehand this time. A little bit of a lob return from Li Qian gives Suss the height, and he takes full advantage at 6-5. And another lovely little shape up down that backhand court this time. In fact, I think there was a little bit of kidology here, shaped up to play it cross, and then just allowed that elbow out a bit more, played it down the line, and that was good work from Suss, who now is in the lead at 7-5, 5-7. The 56 ranked in the world, playing the number one and holding well, 6-7. Well, we knew it was going to take the game of his life by Christian Suss to get even close. He is playing the game of his life, he is close. But it's not quite enough at the minute. At 7-7, it's looking ominous. Just 4 more points for Li Qian, and the match is gone. Well, depending on which team you're on, of course. Great defense. Seuss again finds that backhand coming to his rescue, blocks it, and still gets a little bit of underspin on it. And that's the second time in this match he picks up an unorthodox service. Look at that, shaped up to play it across, tucks it underneath his arm. Point, 9-7. 7-9. He's been here before and lost it.
8-9.
It was 9. It was 9 in the first. He was leading 10-7 in the second and lost it. He's still got 1 point advantage, as Christian Seuss. Can he take advantage of it right here?
The crowd are hushed and they are tense.
And that's at 9-9, and Lee Chin is really excited by that. It's the speed that deceives Seuss. He doesn't expect it coming so early to him. 9-9, but Germany have the service. And that is match point then. Now match point to Wang Lijin. And the Germans call a timeout, trying to salvage this position. I must say, I think Christian Seuss has played a brilliant match. He's struggling at the final death throws, but Wang Lijin has been pushed all the way. And there have been moments when Christian Seuss has had a lot of questions to be answered, opposed a lot of questions. It's at the end, it's at the business end of every game that Wang Lijin has managed to come through. And there it is, match ball. It will be Seuss to serve. But this to level the series in this team competition at 1-1. That's it! Great defense, a brilliant effort by Seuss. But Wang Lijin wins it by 11-9 in the third game. And 3-0 overall then. A brave, brave fight by the 56th seeded in the world, Christian Seuss. But as expected, the world champion and the number one seed, Lee Chin, manages ultimately to come through and win by 3-0. That was Marlin losing to Timo Boll after a brilliant match. Boll coming back from two love down to win 3-2. And then Christian Suss has just lost out to Wang Lichin. A very close contest. Three love he lost, but it was 9-11, 11-13, 9-11. And now we have... It's Wang Hao together with Zoltan Fejikonov. And let me tell you, this is going to be a very big battle in prospect because Christian Suss was not given much hope of winning, but Zoltan Fejikonov certainly is. The umpire Lovik Fed of Denmark has tossed the coin, and the 27-year-old, the most experienced, the oldest in the German squad, Zoltan, will be trying to upset the form books. You see his rank at 41, is significantly lower than his opponent, who is ranked at 3. There he is, 22 years old, Hao Wang. The most frustrating thing for the rest of the world is that there are hundreds of top, top Chinese table tennis players just waiting to take over in the wings. Hao Wang has just come to the surface at the moment, ranked at number 3, just at 22 years old. The Chinese squad is in fantastic shape. They haven't lost any kind of competition for many years. And they've won this particular tournament on no less than 14 different occasions. So unless Germany can pull off a miracle right now, that particular record is going to continue. Just to remind you that Germany lost to China in the last team championships in Doha, Qatar, in 2004. And on that occasion, it was a clean sweep. They lost by 3 matches to love. But already that particular position has been upset with Boll's win over Marlin. So a quiet anticipation in here in the AWD Dome. And I can tell you now that if Zoltan can be as inspired as Suss, then he may well give Wang Hao a big, big battle. All to play for here, it's one all. China versus Germany, China in serve with Wang Hao. Ooh, that was just the edge of the table. And that augurs well, doesn't it? Just off the edge. It's one all. That's good movement by Zoltan Feyer. The Zugbrücker Grenzauer player has really got a big battle on his hands. It's back to 2-2. But he's got a great physique for this game. It's 3-2 to China. Well, a good rally there, but in the end, a mistake from Zoltan. Got a little tied up, way, way out of court. Good pressure there from Wang Hao. It's 2-4. Oh yeah, great shot. Beautifully anticipated from the service, look at that. Really well undercut, but look, it was almost flat, that penholder grip of the bat by Wang Hao, and he just absolutely flew it down that backhand line. A bit aggressive there, but he's certainly trying all the shots even at this early stage of the match.
The strategy is to try to pull and push his opponent all around the table. Zoltan goes for the quick kill, misses. And that's a better one. Oh, yes. This is a very... It stood up a little bit, and Zoltan really pounced on it. Good work. A little error this time, and it's very much a cat-and-mouse game. Some very, very small nuances of spin will be enough to put the opponent off. And a little word from the coaching bench as Zoltan prepares again at 4-7. Oh, that was unlucky, actually, because he moved so quickly into position for that backhand. Brilliant piece of play there. What a great get-back. A little... Well, it was there, wasn't it, for the taking? But Zoltan... not quite able to keep it in control and on the table, so he's back by 4 points at the moment at 8-4. And now 9-4. And Wang Hao starting out with very, very positive body language. Zoltan trying hard to stay in this opening game. Again, it was the spin that deceived right at the net. And that is game point to the Chinese Wang Hao. And, well, that is it. And a pretty sort of low-key affair, really, that opening game. 11-5 it was to Wang Hao in the end. And Zoltan just couldn't cope with the Chinese all-round game. It was pretty aggressive, and I think that the coaching bench there with Dirk Schimmelpfennig being quite demonstrative in his advice, it's really got to lift him as much mentally as anything. Zoltan appears to be on the back foot. His opponent, on the other hand, is really steaming along and trying all the shots. And there you can see the result, 11-5 in this opening game. In the quarterfinal, Germany beat Russia, which was a great win by three matches to love. And that was a very, very big moment in this packed stadium. And there are the Chinese supporters, the clappers and the Chinese flag in prominence. So we're in the second game now with Zoltan Vyakonath in service, having lost the opening game, 1-1. Well, has he come out with a bit more of an aggressive perspective? The coaches have had a chance to see how the various the opponent is playing and the tactic, but Wang Hao has just got such an all-round competent game, the number three in the world. He's not that tall, he's not that big a reach, but I tell you, he's got a fabulous understanding of this game. And he reads the opponent very well. Again, that stretch by Zoltan goes long. It's 2-1. Oh, what a beautiful piece of play by Wang Hao. That is really stunning. Such quick reflexes. What he lacks in
in range, he makes up for in speed. That ball has to be tossed at least 16 centimetres in the air from the palm, with no variation in terms of the movement on the ball for spin. All the spin is imparted from the bat itself, and there's a lot of that, particularly from this young man, Wang Hao. 4-1 he leads. And again, it was that improvisation by Wang Hao. That little backhand, look at the spin on it. It's just extraordinary. How do you even attempt to control that? Great shots there from the cameraman. 5-1, China leads, and are looking very solid. There's not a great deal that Zoltan Fayakonath can do about it at the minute. And again, he's too aggressive. Look at it, it's the underspin there that causes the problems. It looked to be setting up for an easy kill. And again, he's actually outfoxing his opponent. It's not just that he's got all the shots. He's looking at where he's positioned at the table and putting very, very big pressure on. It's now 7-1, 1-7. Well, the first error of the second game for Wang Hao. That's good eyes on that ball. That's a lovely slow-mo there. Oh, yeah. Too good. Can't deny this one. Look at it. That's so straightforward. The clenched fist followed immediately after the shot. He wasn't even waiting for the result. He knew it was there. And again, it's all a procession at the moment. And from a fantastic atmosphere where the crowd were really into this, it's rather gone off the boil somewhat. And again, it's now game point for the second time to Wang Hao of China against Zoltan Fayakonath, the German in service. And again, it was too aggressive by Wang Hao. And he takes the second one, this time by a margin of 11 points to 2. And there's definitely the writing on the wall with this. Zoltan Fayakonath has not been able to read the opponent. He's not been able to get into a position of putting any pressure on. So consequently, even with that one, you see it was off the net and the spin was affected even more. As we see a couple of these slow-mos, probably the final points coming up. It's pressure. It's pressure that will dictate. And again, that is confident play by the Chinese Wang Hao. Plays for the Bank of China, Club 81. World team champion, of course, in 2004. Third place in the World Cup in 2004. Runner-up in the Olympics in the same course in 2004 in Athens. So I had the great privilege to attend. And it's now going to be a big battle. Look at that. The scores of 11-5, 11-2 tell it all, with Wang Hao looking very solid to take this third match of this semi-final series. But the first point there to Zoltan of this third game. Something really special here is required. A complete turnaround, but we're not going to get that, I don't think. That loose shot from Zoltan, the forehand, there was no attempt to spin it. It's just a forcing shot that went long. 1-1.
wasn't even close with that, was he? The crowd, the German crowd, trying to lift their third player. And they've got him back to 2-2, but it's all a little bit low-key at the minute. Waiting for the inevitable. That's a better shot. Zoltan needs to get that pumped. His body language pumped up. He needs to get a little bit more confident. He's back on his heels a little bit too much at the minute. There's no pressure on Wang Hao. And with a shot like that, it will continue to be an easy road at 3-3. First and foremost, you have to keep the ball in play. Then you've got to force the errors, or you've got to attempt to push your opponent around. And Zoltan is not doing any of those things. That under chop there, too good. So Wang Hao continues with his dominant position, leading by 2-0. And there's a timeout called by Dirk Schimmelfennig. And Zoltan really doesn't want to listen, does he? It's very, very difficult when you have a player that is being dominated so comprehensively to get him back up. And this young man, Wang Hao, is in absolutely inspired form at the moment. The stadium announcer trying to get the crowd involved, and to be fair, this 10,000 crowd have really, really tried to support. But it hasn't happened, although that's a point to Zoltan. Again, even when he does try to become aggressive, he hasn't quite got the control to pull it off. That was halfway down the net, not even close. It was a net call, so that would be a reservice. It'll stay at 5-4. Yep, it was a touch. Again, it touches the net and goes out of play. Anxiety from Zoltan as opposed to control. Big, big sweep. Heavy topspin. No good. So China at 6-4. Yes. Can't quite make it happen, can he, Zoltan? He's in the rallies, but he's finding the top of the net so regularly. There's no way that it's going to go in his favour. Oh, yes. What a wonderful backhand there from Wang Hao. He really shaped up there. Look at this. And leans away, little jump, two-footed jump, gets high off it. And again, we'll have a look at this. From the body, bang, down the line. Super shot. Absolutely brilliant. So much confidence and timing there. And this is a procession. Wang Hao's just got too much ammunition, he's got too much confidence, he's absolutely wiping his opponent away. 9-4. 9-5, that's the best score, equal to the best score that Zoltan has made.
He lost the first game 11-5, so let's see if we can improve on that. Total of 5. And he has. a little net cord to make it happen, but 6-9. Match. Spectacular style. Christian Suss lost out to world champion and number one Li Qin. And now this one looks like Wang Hao is very close to victory. He just needs 2 more points with Zoltan in service at 6-9. Good rally for Zoltan. 7-9. Now that was a bit more aggressive. Came from high on the ball and really pushed it heavy top. 9-7. And again, it was a little bit lucky. Oh, spectacular stuff. The crowd loved to see that deep, deep play and the heavy, heavy smashes. And it was came from a little bit of luck at the net, originally from Zoltan, and then he wound up a few and let him go for a point there. So it's not over yet at 8-9. Top of the bat, 9-8. And 10-8, and that is match point to Wang Hao of China. A better and braver fight in this third game by Zoltan Fiaconeth. But it all looks very ominous now as it's 2 match points to Wang Hao. And that's it, that is the match. And it was 8 in the third. The crowd are a bit subdued with that, but no doubt at all, Wang Hao had too much power, showed his great style as the world's number 3 against the world 41 player. And in truth, Zoltan Fiaconeth was nowhere in it. He struggled to find any kind of form at all, and although he pulled back a few points in that third game, he really didn't have any answers for the questions posed by Wang Hao. And that is it. The clenched fist, the scream, and the turn away to the coaching bench to say, right, we are now 2-1 in the lead, and with the sumptuous prospect of Timo Boll to play against Li Qin in the next match. I can tell you, we're all looking forward very much to the fourth.
Wang Yiping, China, gegen unsere Weltrangliste Nummer 2, der hier ja vorhin schon so begeisterndes Tischtennis gezeigt hat. Und der heißt Timo!
There's no doubt that this young man, Timo Boll, is not just a great personality, he's a cult hero in Germany. His ambition to go to China and learn Chinese, can you imagine? He's going to spend a lot of time in China prior to the Olympics. And his ambition really is to upset the Chinese in their own backyard. There he is. He is, he's really the only player in the men's world of table tennis that has any chance at all upsetting the balance of form. And the top 6 players, 3 of them, 4 of them in fact are Chinese. The only other one is Vladimir Samsonov of Bulgaria. I beg your pardon, Belarus, who is in 5th position overall. But it's this young man who survived a real battle by Christian Zeus to take the second match 3-love. It's going to be fascinating to see whether Bol can push him even harder this time round. They'll just warm up for a couple of moments. We've been through a little of the background and heritage of these players, but Timo Boll there at 25 years old, ranked 2 in the world. He is a bit of a phenomenon, the left-hander. He has upset the top players on more than one occasion. And at this level, of course, it's as much mental as physical talent. If the opponent knows that you have the game to beat him, then it's just puts the odd little moment of doubt. Whereas Li Qin knew that he could beat Christian Zeus. Zeus had no worries at all about attempting some crazy aggressive stuff. In normal circumstances, he probably wouldn't do. Bol, on the other hand, knows that he has a chance against Li Qin. So it's going to be a fascinating tactical battle here, I think. Whether they're going to be aggressive, whether they're going to watch for others to make mistakes. They've all got the range of shots. Bol definitely favors the forehand top. Li Qin has really got an all-round game, but they both love to wind it up and get very, very hard and aggressive. It's been noticeable since we've been here this week in Bremen that there is a fascinating interest in all table tennis, the history of table tennis, although obviously the museum is in Lausanne, the main museum, the ITTF. We have some of those exhibits here in Bremen, and there's been hundreds and hundreds of people going through and having a look at these. Fascinating to watch how the people here in Bremen have taken this table tennis championships to their hearts. They've been coming to the exhibitions, they've been involved in all kinds of table tennis, big tables, little tables. They've been part of seminars, the children have been painting thousands and thousands of little bats. So it's been a wonderful occasion here in Bremen. And here is the ultimate. Can they now, Germany, can they now dent some of the pride of this very, very impressive Chinese team? Li Qin against Timo Boll. Li Qin is starting out very aggressively. Timo Boll had to come back from 2 games down in his opening game. The way this is starting, he may have to do the same. Again, it's the speed of Li Qin. It's so difficult to harness. Good point there, though, for Timo. Beautiful inside out, kept his elbow down, forced the ball out wider. Good stuff. 3-2. It's no wonder it's got a great following, I must say. It's a great TV game, there's no doubt about that, but when you see it in the flesh, it really is so impressive, the speed of these guys, the iron-hand coordination, the fitness levels. So Germany will be in service at 2-4. And Li Qin really opening up very aggressively.
Go.
A bit more patience from Timo, pays off there. Good serve. Go. Li Qin just pounces on everything. Doesn't matter what what is served up to him in terms of the spin. He just comes really at it. And again, he's opening up now an impressive gap. It was all opened up there, waiting for that very aggressive forehand top. Just off the edge. Again, too quick. Heavy top. That bat is almost horizontal as the ball is struck. Timo Boll refuses to buckle at the moment. He's still within touch at 5-7. Just a little block. And there, look at that. How horizontal is that? Wow. A little error there of judgment by Timo. Thought he had that one covered, but extra little spin. Doesn't take much. Well, I think Timo Boll was a little bit fortunate there. Li Qin couldn't believe his luck. The ball really sat up and then it was knocked out of play. Still 2 points the difference at 6-8. That's a let. That's good stuff at 7-8. Well, if anything's going to get this crowd on its feet, it'll be the comeback king, Timo Boll, taking this opening game. I tell you what, it's going to be something special if he manages it. Oh, that was so unlucky. 9-7. It's all in the game. Well, you've got to put that behind you. Get on with it. 9-7. And two good by Li Qin, makes it 10-7 and game ball. This opening game of the fourth match. It's the men's team event, first semi-final stage. And he's still there, 2 points adrift. Li Qin trying to finish off this opening game. He's got a 2 point advantage and should do it. But that was a lovely little chop by Boll to force the error. But that's the opening game, and it's 11-8 to China. Wang Li Qin. So, Wang opened up well. He had a 3 point advantage before he conceded one. So, he's aggressive from the start. But Timo Boll kept in there, kept working at his defense. But in the end, it was this fantastic athlete, Li Qin, who wins the opening game. He's always done more weight training than anyone else in the sport. Believe it or not, Li Qin is also a passionate Formula One supporter. His ambition, he says, is to be able to speak with Michael Schumacher. Well, he's in the right country, although
Schumacher doesn't spend much time here. But perfection is what Schumacher has attempted over his sporting life, and that's also what this young man is attempting as well. He's opened up well with an 11-8 game to take the first in this fourth match. Germany need to win it to stay in the competition. Oh, and it's repaid now, that little top of the net and over. Good fortune there for Timo.
But the one he conceded was at a very, very important stage.
This is the early part of this second game. Not quite so vital at the moment, but he's taken a 2-love advantage. Way back from the table and lots of time to look at it, but that was heavy spin. Look at that. Wow, that really did kick high from Li Qin. Very, very big, heavy looping shot. And two all. The left-hander there looking round for inspiration. He's not going to get it. Wow, unplayable ball by Li Qin. Watch this, look at the spin. Oh, absolutely extraordinary. How did he clear the net, get that kind of spin, and that whipping away from the left-hander as well? Remarkable shot. Three all though.
Three.
Timo is still hanging in here. If he can just snatch a couple of points, put a bit more pressure on, force the aggression. It ain't gonna happen like that. 4-3 to Li Qin. Too easy. Again, he maneuvered that rally to such a position that Timo Boll had nowhere to go. Look at him, squeezed out there, way, way out on the backhand side, but trying to play a forehand to... It's just so, so good piece of play that by Li Qin. Timo Boll will not sit down, will he? He is just working so hard. Defending well, quietly at it. He's opened up with a lead, but he's now back at 5-all, having lost the first. That is good stuff from Timo Boll. Beautiful. Very good. He used the net, obviously, there, and there was an element of luck in that, but... he deserved that. He shaped up well, played a really good rally. And so he takes the position of... and thought that actually it was going to be... Yes, it is 7-5. I think the scoreboard there is wrong. I assume that it would be 6-5 to Germany. So let's hope that's resolved. I think it is 7-5 now to Germany. And that's off the end of the table, so I think it is 7-5 on the scoreboard. We've all changed now, and good for that. So it's 7-6. You know, it was struck with such strength and such heavy spin, he just had to keep going away with it.
Brilliant play by Li Qin. Oh, and then, even better, swifter play by Timo Boll. Marvellous backhand. Look at that. Absolutely brilliant. Tried to look him in the eye as well. It's all gamesmanship, isn't it? It's all about ascendancy. You've got to put one over on your opponent, not just on the court, but also with the confidence as well. Snatched at that one and wished he hadn't. Seven, eight, getting to the business end of this second game. A lot of tension here. And Timo has conceded another point to 8-all now. The crowd again trying to inspire the home favourite. But at 8-all, he needs all his courage to come through this one. That's a better shot. Beautifully set up. The serve was good. Forced the return to be just a little bit high. And then a lovely finishing shot by Boll. Forces the error from Li Qin. So he takes the lead to 9-8. Back to 9-all. The tension is too much for some of us here. It certainly is stimulus and response stuff, isn't it? Really, you get the opportunity for so much kill and thrust and euphoria and dejection. It's all in every game. Every emotion. And that's a good one there from Li Qin. And with just one more point, he will secure a two-game advantage in this match. Surely we can't expect Timo Boll to come back from that. He managed just that in the first game against Ma Lin. But Li Qin is a totally different prospect. It's therefore game ball for Wang Li Jin. Oh, it's not yet over. It's gone to deuce at 10-all. Well, I don't know about you around the world, but I am thoroughly enjoying this match. Absolutely stunning stuff. Great tension, great athleticism, wonderful table tennis, and above all, a magnificent atmosphere. Game point to Timo Boll. Bring it on, says the German crowd. Wow, big moment this. If he can level it, the confidence just might build to take it on and win it, but he's got to win this point. No, it's 11-all. Too quick by Li Qin. I don't mean to sound as if I'm supporting the Germans, but I just feel because they're such underdogs that and there is such great atmosphere and home support here, I'd just love to see a really competitive match. And that's a great point from Timo Boll. How on earth did he get that point on? My goodness, that was just superb. Let's have a look at this rally. He looked like he'd lost it three times. He caught the edge there of the table, that 2-centimetre line, and that was a superb moment. Wow, this is it. Concentration now building. 12-11 to Germany. China in service. One more point. Yes, he got it! Wow! And Timo Boll, the hero of Germany, takes it the second game, and we are in for a magnificent...
magnificent battle. Well, I don't know about the guys on the table, but this is...
And Richard Krause did not expect that. It's a fantastic performance there by Timo Boll.
So there we go, 13-11 was the score. It's one all in games. Germany are 2-1 down in matches. So, Boll has got to win two of the next three games in order to keep his team in the match.
1-0.
Just to remind you, this is the first semi-final of the men's team table tennis championships 2006. We are at the AWD Dome Bremen, and we have a fabulous battle with China playing Germany. China the clear favorites, defending champions, champions 14 occasions previously, and Germany absolutely fighting for their lives. What a point that is from Timo Boll of Germany. Well, he might have been a secret weapon once, but he's no secret anymore. He certainly is the real deal, this Timo Boll. What a fabulous rally. And Li Qin must have the odd moment of doubt. Well, I should have kept my mouth shut too, shouldn't I, there? Li Qin comes through with a fabulous backhand there to pick up the point. But won't see better table tennis than this on the planet. Not only they're fighting for their own pride, but they're that of their nation. Aha. So, China take a 3-2 lead. And again, there's such small tolerances when you're playing these shots. I mean, that was an absolutely flat, horizontal bat by Boll. It's no wonder he missed it. 3-3. Too aggressive from Timo, so he drops a point back. But he is in service at 3-4. Well, we've seen some spectacular shots and some indifferent ones. That shot comes into the latter category. China in service at 5-3, Li Qin trying to regroup, having lost the second game. Gladiators in great, oh, what a shame. Absolutely at the top level, I was about to say. Gladiators at the top level of their game. Giving no quarter, expecting no quarter, and look at the distance that Li Qin was back then. He was at least 5 meters back from the table. Absolutely amazing. Look at him. Still playing. Absolutely brilliant stuff. It's no wonder that the ITTF president, Adam Sharara, is absolutely delighted with the progress of this game around the world. TV coverage is making a huge difference, of course. I'll give you some stats in a minute about that TV coverage and the number of people who are watching. It's quite extraordinary. Li Qin is not letting up, and then he takes a 3-point advantage here. Xia Yao
Chayo.
Well, tit for tat.
The German crowd are just so wishing for something spectacular. They've already had the second game that was special. Timo Boll always fighting to get into the match. Lee Chin dominant and then falling back a little bit. It's a fantastic battle. 7-5. How is that? Goodness. 8-5. And Timo did everything possible there. Great wrist stuff, but then he just wasn't in perfect position to play that smash and just dropped it long. But it was a fabulous rally. Once again, we're being treated to the best there is. Set itself up. Lee Chin took advantage, and there we go, 9-5. Looking ominous. He's back at his absolute best. He's recovered from that little setback of the second game. And now, wow. Timo didn't even have a chance to put an attempt to play it. That's a better backhand. Still there. He's got to still believe. And that heavy top kept the ball very, very low. Again, it was Lee Chin who was the aggressive one with the backhand. It touched the net and then forced that error from Boll. So it is now. It's game point for the third game. It was a let. This is exciting stuff, isn't it? Oh, Timo Boll slipping over there to the left. The left-handed forehand picks up the point. 10-7. It ain't done yet. Oh, yes. What a great defense by Lee Chin. Timo was going to still stay in that one until Lee Chin really forced the error, and it was 11-7 in the end. Well, we're concentrating on the big one, China versus the host nation, Germany. And it's all on this particular game, because if Wang Lee Chin wins this one, Germany goes straight through to the final. Boll has got to stop that. Good start. That's too low. Quick thinking by Wang Lee Chin. He could see the opportunity there so fast. Look at that flick over the top. And not a chance there for Boll to get it back. 1-2. To all. And the first time we've heard any kind of frustrating noise from Timo Boll. He's bouncing. He's 2-2. He's got to win this. Great defense, and what an attacking shot. Wow.
That is really athletic. Just got into such beautiful shape. The brilliant balance on his feet to make this one.
Well, that was a surprise. Lee Chin normally would have shaped up with an aggressive shot at that stage of exchanges, but he decided to let Timo play that role, and he fluffed it. Too long. So it's evens at threes. And now 4-3 to Li Chen. It's when he came back onto that forehand side. Maybe he should have just held on that backhand for one more shot. Choices and options, whether by choice or forced, is what this game is all about. And that's a good heavy top back. Forced the ball long at 4-all now. This is such an exposed sport, particularly in front of the TV cameras and the 10,000 in the stadium here. There is not one single place to hide. Aha! Well, Li Chin decides to play inside out, overplays it. Let's have a look at it again. Keeps that elbow tucked in and forces the error. And little blows of frustration from the Chinese camp behind as they see their player fall back by 1 point. Well, that was a bit unlucky because that ball really sat up well for Timo Boll. Sat up well off the net and he missed it. Well, frustration there, 5-all. There's a kind of smirky smile on Wang Li Chin's face at the minute as he realizes he's escaped. 5-all. Oh, what a shot. That is a brilliant shot down the line from the center. Both players superbly aggressive there, but look at that from nowhere. I don't think that Boll could have seen the ball until it was past him. Came from underneath the table. Whoa, don't they like that one? That is an absolutely crucial ball at a crucial time to take the lead now at 6-5, Wang Li Chin. And a 7-5 advantage. It's slipping away now from Germany after all the hopes and all the ambitions. They have got to stop Li Chin making another 3-4 points. Ah, head down, shaking. The crowd really trying to lift their hero. But this man, Li Chin, is looking really, really solid. 7-5 China lead, Germany with the serve. Oh, an uncharacteristic error from Li Chin. Just 1 point back. And another one which levels it at sevens. So Li Chin, a little bit too aggressive there. Some excellent play from Timo Boll. Keeps the pressure on, keeps the match alive. That's three in a row for the German. Well, I can't believe we're going to see yet another recovery. Surely, surely not. That's much too good a prospect for us. It's still there. It's still possible. Great atmosphere, wonderful stadium, brilliant setting, fantastic pairing. And just too much there at 8-all now. Good work by Lee Chien. He forced his opponent to the forehand side and drifted it into the left. Look at that. Beautiful anticipation. Eight all. 3 points. It's a must win for Timo Boll. A need to win by Lee Chien. And wow, 9-8. Are we going to be entertained to yet another fifth game? I love it when Timo Boll actually stares down his opponent after putting a fabulous shot. 9-8 and serving Germany. And 10-8. Oh, dear. Well, don't go and make a cup of tea yet or a coffee, because this is just edge of the seat stuff. There's a lot of white knuckles in this stadium right now, let me tell you. There's a big, big fist of a knuckle with Timo Boll, 2 points for this game, with Lee Chien serving, and the German crowd here are absolutely ecstatic. Oh,
dear. 9-10.
How close, how close. That's great play by Lee Chien, you have to admit. Under pressure, 2 points back. He's only 1 point back now. It's still game point to the German. A must win for Germany. A need to win for Lee Chien of China. And that's it, yay! We go into a fifth game in this fantastic match. China-Germany, my God. Well, we were hoping for something special. We have been given some unbelievable excitement here in Bremen. What a performance by Timo Boll. He was down and out for all the world, struggling. Final match. It's all looking wonderful. Can't blame them for getting excited.
China will serve 0-0.
Well, they've never been this close, let me tell you. Even when they played Doha, Germany and China, the Chinese team won 3-0. And in fact, the German team only actually won two games in that 3-love defeat.
1-0.
Every point is so vital. China have the first. And the second. Good play by Lee Chien. Too much pressure here. Excellent stuff. That was a very good backhand. You see the way that he was so balanced on his feet. He got into great position, then flexed that wrist over the top. Forced the error. But a good, good response there from Timo Boll. There are very few sports where you're so under the microscope. It's a small playing surface. It's an enormous game. And let me tell you, both these players are playing at the top of their game. Entertainment aplenty. Look at that, all the twos. 2-2, 2-2. It's the Chinese Wang Lijin that breaks that deadlock. just couldn't quite get into position to play it off his chest there. China is still in serve at 3-2. Three hole. Oh, yes. Well, if you're watching table tennis for the first time, let me tell you, you're very lucky, because this is as the game is played at the absolute top, top level. Do I need to say anything? Timo Boll takes the lead. The crowd's reaction says it all. A resigned look from Lee Chin says it all. Germany with the service now at 4-3. And at 5-3. My palms are sweating. I don't know about the players. Well, there is a timeout called. Wow. Wow, wow. Covered sports for 26 years, over 28 sports, and I tell you, this is as good as it gets in terms of competition. This is absolutely riveting. Ping pong diplomacy, 17-1, I think, as we were talking about 35 years ago. Ping-pong diplomacy between the US and the Chinese started in the World Championships in Nagoya, Japan, 35 years ago. Really fascinating story that ended up with Nixon, of course, going to China. But I tell you what, there is a lot of ping-pong diplomacy going on here tonight. It is serious, but without question, it is going to bring a huge number of new fans to the game. There's a let. Tension. The crowd are totally absorbed. And a point for China, 4-5. I was going to mention the viewing figures. Let's talk percentages. In Barcelona, Adam Shahara, he said that out of the 26 sports, table tennis was the 24th in terms of viewership numbers. In Athens in 2004, table tennis had moved up to 5th out of 28 sports. By Beijing in 2008, table tennis will be in the top 3. And it's because of the play of these guys, the way in which they're playing, that the sport is so popular now around the world. A great disappointment there for Timo Boll and for the German fans, as Lee Chin takes 3 points in a row, takes a 6-5 advantage here. And this, don't forget, is the 5th game. That is a great shame for Timo Boll. Played everything very aggressively. Wonderful defense by the world champion Lee Chin. And eventually it was a mistake by. He saw it open because Lee Chin went to ground. He saw the opening Timo Boll. He got very excited at the prospect of killing that one. And instead stuck it in the net. Watch it. Again, he's just defending. Big, big high one. Then down he goes. One more. There's the split. Now he gets excited. He's going to put it on the open side, but into the net. Well, Don't say that there's no drama in this game. It's live. It's brilliant. Great entertainment. Look how far they're playing the ball from the table tennis surface. That's playing square of 14 meters long, 7 meters wide. And I can tell you now, it is two big boys that are filling that space. Still, Timo is the shout. 2.74 meters long, that table tennis table, and 1.5 wide. It's not big, is it, when you're under this kind of tension? So, 2 points adrift. China in the lead, 7-5. And 8-5 now. 3 points away from victory and moving on into the final tomorrow. What a battle. Timo Boll is not out of it yet, but he needs to score a couple of quick points to get back into it. And that's 9-5, and Boll 40 was having a chance there, but Lee Chin was just too quick, too steady, too consistent. And that ball into the body forced the error. 9-5, 2 points from victory, 2 points to go through to the final. And that's now 1 point, 5 match points to Wang Lijin of China. And after the great excitement and the unbelievable atmosphere and pressure, it looks like this final game is going to go to China, is it? Oh, no, not yet. Not yet. Well, in a way, it would be a little bit anticlimactic if it was lost now, with the crowd a little bit turned down, but you can't take anything away from this young man, Wang Lijin. Match point. And that's it! China go through to the final of the 2006 World Team Table Tennis Championships at the AWD Dome here in Bremen. They have beaten Germany by 3-1. A fantastic match, wonderful table tennis, an exhibition par excellence by the world number one and number two. A great fight by Germany, but in the end, China, the favorites, go through. Well, you can see there, a standing ovation there for both players, a brilliant match. They were hoping for a miracle, it didn't happen, but by golly, it was a really, really good battle. And no one can take anything away from either of the players here. Timo Boll having beaten Ma Lin earlier, then just loses out to Wang Lijin of China. 11-6, I beg your pardon, in the fifth and final game of their match. Great stuff.
Da bin ich ganz sicher, neben uns steht jetzt der Mann, meine Damen und Herren, der diese Mauer fast eingerissen hätte. Timo, du bist auf der Welt schon ein bisschen rumgekommen, was Tischtennis-Zahlen angeht. Eine solche Atmosphäre schon mal erlebt?
Das war ja besser als in China. Vielen Dank für die tolle Unterstützung.
You can see what it means to the coaching bench from China, to Liu Guoliang, who in his day was World Cup.